The Madison community has had lengthy discussions about the achievement gap, and that's just one of the lessons a new class at the UW is exploring. Andy Choi shows us how the hip-hop culture can potentially be part of that educational equation.
That's right. Sarah and Eric, when most think of hip-hop, they think of catchy rap songs on the radio with little to no academic value. But a group of educators say there are lessons behind this very popular culture.
In the bodega, a young girl wearing jeans so tight.
A language often lost in translation speaks to Michael Sorelli's soul.
The song on the radio said that the po-po was trying to catch me riding dirty. To me,
but the spoken word artist admits hip-hop is a culture misunderstood.
These words make me feel old and white.
I'm from the sound of Philadelphia and the pulse of Black America, where street thugs are a dime a dozen and street poets are a precious gift.
Professor Gloria Latson-Billings with UW's Department of Curriculum and Instruction says the culture of hip-hop may be an untapped source for educators.
There's a whole new vibe that young people are into, and we're ignoring it, and we're missing an opportunity.
So I dust it off with my fossil brush and try to jam it into the keyhole of academia.
It's why Latson-Billings is teaching a new kind of class, showing her students how to think critically about hip-hop's music, artwork, and design, and how the lessons of the culture can serve a diverse group of students.
I think it is a both and. I think that the kids we're not getting to will certainly like doing this kind of work and including this kind of work. But I also think some of the kids who have been just fine in the traditional setting will get even more energized and more exciting.
And it's so relevant for young people. It's sort of what we grow up with. It's part of our lexicon. It doesn't matter if you're from New York City or from Madison, Wisconsin.
Sorelli admits hip-hop is constantly evolving.
Words like for shizzle, crunk, hella.
But the lyricist says it's a culture worth discovering.
It always feels amazing to share your work, to sort of tell your story.
Students enrolled in this class will hear from guest speakers from all over the country on issues ranging from the business of hip-hop to how rapper Jay-Z's words can even engage today's youth to excel.
Now, we know hip-hop and rap, there's some critics because of the explicit lyrics. Is that addressed in the class at all?
Yeah, you know, Professor Latson-Billings says this was actually the first time that she had to write a disclaimer on a syllabus warning students some of the class material will contain content that's profane, misogynist, racist, and homophobic. Latson-Billings says there is no way to avoid this if you want to have a real, unfiltered discussion about the value and evolution of hip-hop. So a lot of places to discuss.
All right. Thanks so much, Andy. Great story. Mm-hmm.
And you can check out a series of free public lectures on hip-hop and education. The first of those lectures starts at the top of the hour tonight. The 13-week seminar is at Granger Hall on the UW campus. Tonight's session will go from 7 to 9 p.m.